When you model a hierarchical data structure, you often have to use self-referencing associations. Both ends of these associations are of the same type. In your database, you model that using a foreign key column that references the same table's primary key. Hi, I'm Torben Janssen, and today I will show you how to model self-referencing associations with JPA and Hibernate. If you're new to this channel and you want to learn how to create your entity mappings with ease, build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring, and all types of other Java persistence-related stuff, subscribe and click the bell to get new videos every week. And also don't forget to like this video, that helps me to reach a broader audience. A typical example of a self-referencing association is a person who has other persons as their parents. You can model it as a uni- or bidirectional many-to-many association on the person entity. Another example is a category that is a subcategory of another category. You can model that as a uni- or bidirectional many-to-one, one-to-many association. During your requirements analysis, these kinds of associations often seem to be very simple. But when you implement your mappings and business code, you quickly recognize that these mappings introduce several pitfalls. In this video, I want to show you the most common ones of these pitfalls. You can avoid most of them relatively easily in your application. But for others, you might want to consider using a totally different approach, for example, a graph database. Pitfall 1. Managing associations. As for all association mappings, you need to decide if you want to map it uni- or bidirectionally. A unidirectional mapping only models the association in one direction, for example, from a child to their parents. A bidirectional mapping would also model the association from each parent to their child. In general, unidirectional associations are easier to update. Bidirectional associations are easier to use in your queries and business code. For most applications, the number and complexity of read operations are a lot higher than for write operations. Because of that, a lot of developers prefer bidirectional mappings. If you decide to use a bidirectional mapping, you always need to update both ends of your association. Otherwise, Hibernate might not persist your change in the database, and the entities in your current persistence context become outdated. The best way to do that for a self-referencing association is to provide utility methods. Their names should represent the actual business operation and perform all necessary validations. For the person example in this video, that might be the method addParents. It adds the two provided person objects to the parents association of a person. Within that method, you could also check that there are no parents set for that person and update the associations on all three person objects. Or you could provide the method createChild. This method instantiates a new person object using the provided first name and last name, adds it to the set of children, and initializes the parents association on the newly created person object. In the category example, the implementation of an add subcategory method or a move category method would require a different association handling. The implementation of the add subcategory method would be straightforward. You instantiate a new category object, add it to the subcategory list of the category object on which you called the method, and set that object as the parent of the newly created category. Moving a category requires an extra step that gets often forgotten. You not only need to add the category object to the subcategories set of the parent and update the parent category reference on your subcategory object, you also need to remove the subcategory object from the subcategories list of the old parent category. Pitfall 2. Fetching behavior. Choosing the wrong fetch type for your associations is always a huge performance risk. That's especially the case for self-referencing associations. Picking the wrong fetch type affects not only a single association in your domain model, but also your entire entity hierarchy. You should always use fetch type lazy for all of your associations. This is the default for all too many associations, and you need to declare it on all of your to one associations. Let's use the category example to see the effect of a missing fetch type declaration for a to-1 association. The following mapping uses the default fetch type eager for the parent association. If you load this entity from the database, Hibernate will initialize the association to the parent entity. When it instantiates the category object for the parent, it also has to initialize its parent association. This process continues until you reach the top of the hierarchy where the parent attribute is null. Depending on your approach to load the category entity, Hibernate might optimize this approach and join a category with its immediate parent in one query. But this still forces Hibernate to execute multiple queries to fetch all levels of the hierarchy. So better double check all your association mappings and make sure you're not using eager fetching. Pitfall 3. Performing queries on your entity hierarchy. You can easily define a query that joins over 2 to 3 levels of your hierarchy. There's no difference between a join over a self-referencing and any other association. As long as you make sure to provide an index for your foreign key column, your database usually handles these queries easily. But for quite a few applications, this isn't good enough. You often need to search all levels of your hierarchy. Depending on the application's domain, this can be less than 5 or several hundred. If your application requires joins over a huge number of hierarchy levels, you might consider using a graph database. They've been specifically developed for these kinds of use cases. Relational databases and SQL are not well suited for that. Another issue when querying self-referencing associations is their initialization. Join fetch clauses and entity graphs enable you to avoid N+1 select issues and to initialize your association efficiently. This also works for self-referencing associations. But you should be aware of an issue that I see very often in my consulting projects. If you use multiple join fetch clauses or complex entity graphs, your SQL query returns a huge product. This often slows down your application. A lot of developers are aware of that, but ignore it for self-referencing associations. That's dangerous because you will experience the same performance issues as with any query that join fetches multiple associations. To fix that problem, you need to split your query into multiple ones, as I explained in a previous video, which you will find in the description. There is not a huge difference between a self-referencing association and an association that references another entity class. But you should pay special attention to the fetch type of your association because it might force Hibernate to fetch the entire hierarchy. Provide utility methods to make managing bidirectional associations easier and not join over too many levels of your hierarchy. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free member library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like a cheat sheet and ebooks about JPA and Hibernate. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!